about 8 people watching already.
Yeah, word off then. I'll get out of the way.
So let's go around. I'll just remember where we're trying to leave. So I'll see you off.
So then it's us off.
125 of you, so right now. Get that.
mate. Sit down, goodness.
No, honestly, I'm fine. I'm fine.
Generous and kind friend who had cheeky sense of humour and was very giggly. He had a punchline for everything and always gave sound advice. He loved the betting on horses, McDonald's and partying hard. Tragically, after returning home, Eamon was diagnosed with MND. This was a huge blow, but Eamon did his very best to stay cheerful and remain upbeat. He will be sadly missed by each and every one of you here today. And there are several of his friends who would like to pay tribute to him. The first person who would like to speak is Tony, who he referred to as his wingman. Would you like to come forward?
With me and Eamon. The first of which was when we were 12, we were staying in the school playground at Dye Martyrs, and a guy threw a herd weight over the school building. 360 kids standing there, me talking to Eamon. Who did it hit? Me, right in the middle of my head. Went down like a sack of shite. Eamon followed me down and put his hand over my head to stop me bleeding out. And the doctor actually said to my mum, that act of Eamon's quite possibly saved my life. And the other incident, because that's what Eamon was like, he just did things off the top of his head, came naturally to him. And the other incidents that I'd like to mention, a few of you might probably already know, he was driving along a main road where he's with his boss, and he saw a bloke in the high street fall down. Eamon told the driver to stop, he legged it out. The guy appeared dead, he gave him artificial resuscitation and saved the man's life. And it was in quite a few newspapers. Things that Eamon never used to brag about, but that's the kind of Eamon was. So thoughtful, that was Eamon. That's all I'm saying, really. That man to death.
Even to this day, those individuals that suffered at that hand cross the road and run the other way to this day, and that was years and years ago. So, say to him is thank you for all of his love and support and help, and how passionate he was about all of his friends, everything that he did it. Stag chili, which you introduced me to about 20 years ago, and it's just little things that I think every day that remind us of the great person that he was, my friend. Stand up and share some of the great times we had together, and again, just celebrate the life that was. So, I'm grateful. himself and me in the room. But aside of the music, what I was met with was this massive ball of energy, this whole bundle of energy that he could move, lift it up, raise it down, and give it to you. And he was a man that was empathetic in that music. And although he made music all the time, what came to me was he could always tell the story of that music. And he was a great storyteller. He was a wonderful man embellishing the feelings behind his music. He didn't play it to be really great music. So myself as a performer, I took this with me and this level of projection. And to this day, I've never met another human being that can do it like he can do it. Dear friend, losing it now. Quick story. I had delivered a lot of severed hands, and the middle finger moves, which enables the hand to go round on the floor. And Eamon was given one of these. He took it to work, and he waited until all his mates were coming back from lunch. And he prepared himself with a few sinews that hung out of his arm like this with a sore thumb. You can tell what's going on. I was a great prankster, but this prank for me was a oh no, don't do that kind of prank. But he did it. So he set the saw up, he put the hand down there, wiggling in the sawdust with blood on, and as soon as the boys came back from work, he toiled the saw on, put a damp piece of wood through the saw, and screamed his head off like only Eamon. Of course, the boys come running in and see this, and he's like, yep. That's a lot. Another story I remember him fondly for was he was with a lot of, let's call it macho types, and his demeanour is always, well, you know, I'm going to be better than you. And so these big boys were with him, normal environmental place, wherever it was, but there was a big black mole spider on the wall, and he noticed that some of these macho types were like, oh, spider. Eamon being Eamon went, what, that spider? And swallowed it in front of him. So he had this amazing ability to capture people and to take them on a journey that only he could take them on. I returned to his house and we would discuss what you would probably think is absolute nonsense, but me as a clown, it was perfect. The man could go off in any direction. He could talk about anything, spiritual, earthwise, you know, any cooking. Oh, he loved to cook. Big homemaker. He loved making his home like when he got to New Zealand. The man built his house himself. He went and worked, turned around, you know, not many friends, built his friends up, became one with the community, and then toured. This beautiful Frank Sinatra show that he put all his time and effort and his money into. And for me, as him as an artist, I wholeheartedly think, you know, in my book, he's one of the best artists I know, and I wish he could have gone further with his music. He loved his carpentry, he loved his carpentry friends, he loved all of his friends. And to this day, I can't believe he's dead.
Thank you.
now time for us to say our final goodbye to Aidan. Please stand for the final. Aidan, we are so grateful that you have been in our lives. Thank you for your hard work and your wonderful achievements. You leave this world a richer place than you found it. You were loving, loyal, and kind, and you will never be forgotten. May you now rest in peace. We are now going to hear one of Eamon's tracks, That's Life, which you want to be played now. And this will be followed by The Last Post. So if you feel able, do keep standing, otherwise stand when it's time for The Last Post.
Down and over and out, and I know I'm blamed.
Did you know Eamon? You didn't know him, did you? Did you?
Yeah, yeah, yeah. I went to school.
Did you? What a character. Top man, mate. He gave me when he